Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm back with an unboxing video. So, just because I am an ambassador of CZX, I do get new stamps and ties that they come up with every now and then, so I thought that it would be fun to show you what I got on my latest box from them. Now, just remember that there are two divisions of CZX. One is responsible for USA and Canada, and the other one, which is located in the UK, is responsible for the rest of the world. And obviously, since I live in Greece, I do get all the products from the UK division. Now, this means that some of the designs might not be available on the US and Canada, but you will find links to everything down below. You will find links to the official website of CZX in the UK, where you can get all those products, as well as on Amazon UK. In any case, if you like anything you see here, just check the links below. So first I'm going to show you the big dies that were included in my box, and let's take a look on the Christmas dies. This is called Angel Number 2, and you can see how big the angel can be. And the die cuts out not only the body for your angel, but also the wings, a little heart, as well as a star. And I really love what they did on the front as an inspiration by wrapping that string with little embellishments. And here's another Christmas die. This is called Oh Christmas Tree, and as you can see, it cuts out two adorable Christmas trees, but at the same time you get cutouts of a star, the bottom where you can nest your tree inside, a little heart, as well as little embellishments to stick on top of your trees. And here is Santa. As you can see, it comes out with different layers, so you can stack one on top of the other and get some dimension. I think he is perfect as a focal point on your Christmas cards, but also he would make great gift tags. And this is the Pretty Climber. As you can see, it's quite big in size. You get those vines, but it also cuts out a separate leaf that you can stick on top to add even more dimension, as you can see on the front. And I'm going to show you how big that vine is, which is perfect even for your art journaling or mixed media projects, but you can also use it on top of a card. And now let's move on to the framelits that I got. So the first one is called Brush Numbers. As you can see, you get all the numbers in a lovely handwritten font, and you also get the word today, so I think that this would be a great set to have for scrapbooking or even project life. Now, another framelit which is perfect for Christmas is Graceful Angel. So this one cuts out different layers for your angel, and you also get the wings that you can use on different projects if you want. And the other one is called Treetops Glisten, which is perfect for Christmas cards. I imagine cutting it out from gold, and it would be the perfect focal point on top of a Christmas card. And now let's move on to two dies that are perfect for backgrounds. So this one is called Moroccan Tile, and I love that it cuts out a frame, and you can actually cut out with different color of cardstock the insides, so you can play around with that. Now I'm going to show you another one, and this is a beautiful doily. It is called Antique Doily, and I hope you can see how intricate and delicate that is. If you love doilies, I think this is a must-have, and I especially love both those dies because I think that they would add a great texture on the background of my mixed media projects and my art journal layouts. So now let's move on to a few fun ones. This is called Animal Portraits, and you see that you get three different animals. This is spooky, so it's perfect for creating Halloween projects, as you can see a witch and a vampire there. And also another one, which is called Rainy Days and Sunshine. So I think that just because these are quite big, they make great focal points for any type of projects, even if it's a bag, a gift bag, or a birthday card, or even a gift tag. And now let's move on to a couple of smaller dies. These are thin lids again. So the first one is called Little Robin, and it cuts out different parts of the bird, so you can use different cardstock and then put it all together. The second one is called Bright Spark, and I love that you get a bunch of different images that you can use to create different clusters on top of your cards, or you can even use it for scrapbooking or even project life. And now let's move on to a couple of facets where you get the die and the stamp as well. So the first one is called Wild Butterfly, and you get a lovely butterfly there, which is a great size. And the second one is a floral cake, perfect for birthdays. And I think that this would go great with the brass numbers. So you can really personalize the card that you make with this birthday cake if you add the age of the recipient. And I'm opening up this package just to test the quality of the clear stamp. And this is the great quality. It's actually a photopolymer clear stamp, which stamps perfectly. It's not silicone, it's not acrylic. So these were all the stamps and dies that I got from Sizzix. I want you to leave me a comment down below and let me know which ones are your favorite. And also let me know which ones you want to see me use on a project in the future. I will read all the comments as I always do, and I am going to make videos with your favorite dies. Now also visit my blog and leave me a comment there, since I will choose one winner who will get two of those dies that I showed you today. I hope that getting a chance to see close-ups of the dies that have been released by Sizzix was helpful for you, and you probably found a couple of dies that you really love. I am going to link you a couple of videos here in case you need more inspiration on how to use Sizzix dies, and I'll see you next time. Thank you all for watching!